What comes first to people's mind when we think of the most common cause of death in the world? Although many of us might think that cancer kills the most people in the world. In fact, more people die from atherosclerotic disease than from cancer in many countries. Atherosclerotic disease include cerebrovascular disease, such as cerebral hemorrhage and infarction, cardiac disease, such as myocardial infarction and cardiac failure, aneurysm, and peripheral arterial disease, PAD, which are all severe or even fatal disease. However, these diseases do not produce significant subjective symptoms and are therefore called silent killers. In addition, once an event occurs, the quality of life or QOL of the patient may be seriously affected. Cerebrovascular disease, especially, frequently forces the patient to become bedridden. These systemic diseases are caused by hardening of the arteries. Obviously, we human beings have to pay attention to the blood vessels. You must have such patients complaining that their legs feel cold and numb, feel pain after walking for a while, or hurt even when staying still.
Ulcer or necrosis.
These complaints may be early signs of peripheral arterial disease or PAD. One of the cardiovascular disease, PAD is a condition that affects blood flow in the arteries. The Fontan classification is a scheme by which symptoms associated with stenosis or occlusion in an artery in the limb are classified and is used to rate the severity of PAD. Atherosclerosis in legs are indicator of systemic atherosclerosis. Therefore, the examination of arterial problems in the legs facilitates the early detection of cerebrovascular disorder and ischemic heart disease. Early detection of PAD allows clinicians to more effectively treat patients, improve their quality of life, and prevent fatal cerebral and cardiac events.
PAD is a disease by which the arteries in the arms and legs harden, leading to stenosis and occlusion, and is frequently associated with cerebrovascular disorder, ischemic heart disease, diabetes, and hypertension. Therefore, 10 years survival rate, the patient with severe PAD is only 10%, and thus PAD is a disease with a poor prognosis. It is said that of approximately 27 million patients with PAD in Europe and North America, 16.5 million have no symptoms. Thus, the importance of early diagnosis was advocated. And in 2007, Task 2 guidelines were developed to provide an international consensus on the diagnosis and treatment of PAD. While the task targeted for only vascular specialists, the Task 2 guidelines were designed to be used by a wider range of clinicians, such as diabetes specialists and primary care physicians, as well as by vascular specialists. Measurement of the ankle brachial index, or ABI, is recommended as a primary non-invasive screening test for PAD. That is, the ABI is an index that should be routinely measured in primary care practice.
Arteriosclerosis is largely divided into two types. One type is classified as atherosclerosis, in which atheroma attaches and accumulates on the blood vessels, causing arterial stenosis. Why is measurement of ABI important? Stenosis or occlusion caused by atherosclerosis frequently occurs in an artery in the lower limb, and the blood pressure at the lesion is decreased. ABI is a simple test to gauge the degree of stenosis. Systolic blood pressure in the ankles is compared to the systolic blood pressure in an arm, which has higher blood pressure. In addition to the patient complaining leg pain, ABI measurement is helpful to detect asymptomatic PAD. Asymptomatic PAD, for the total population with PAD, it is estimated that as many as 50% of them are asymptomatic. Task 2 recommended that measurement of ABI as a primary non-invasive screening test for PAD. According to the guideline, the ABI measurement is mainly indicated for people with higher risk, such as smokers over 50 years old and patients with diabetes. The normal range of ABI is defined as 0.91 to 1.4, and if the index is found to be 0.9 or lower, PAD is suspected. In contrast, if it is 1.4 or higher, the actual condition may not be reflected because the blood vessel is not sufficiently compressed by the cuff due to calcification in the artery in the legs. In such cases, the total blood vessel index or TBI is recommended. Introducing an exciting advancement in preventive cardiovascular care, the VPE1000 Plus, Omron's most innovative non-invasive vascular profiling system. VPE1000 Plus captures two core measurements, ABI and PWI, to accurately assess properties of the arteries and detect potential problems. Perfect for any doctors that deal with cardiovascular disease, diabetes, and internal medicine. Simultaneously, Vascular Angle Plus Wave Velocity, or BAPWI, is also determined. BAPWI is a proven method for helping clinicians assess arterial stiffness. PWI is an index that indicates the hardness of the artery and thus facilitates the detection of another type of arteriosclerosis, such as Monkeberg arteriosclerosis, in which the artery wall hardens. In a distensible healthy blood vessel, the pulsation is absorbed by the arterial wall. But in a sclerotic blood vessel, the pulsation is not absorbed by the arterial wall and thus conducts fast, leading to an increase in the PWI. The fast reflected wave arrives back at the heart. The heart is still in systole.
Patients with PAD frequently have cerebral vascular disorder, ischemic heart disease, diabetes, hypertension, and dyslipidemia as comorbidities. It is reported that in Europe and the United States, dyslipidemia and ischemic heart disease most frequently coexist, accounting for 70% of patients, while in the Asian regions, diabetes and cerebral vascular disease are the most common comorbidities, and the percentage is as high as 40%. Accordingly, in patients with PAD, hard blood vessels should always be suspected.
VPE1000 Plus can be used for the early screening for atherosclerotic disease with simultaneous measurements of ABI and PWI. Well, let's see how to operate the device. The thickness of the pillow is important, since a thick pillow can interfere with the blood flow. A thin pillow is recommended. Ask the patient to take off linsky or thick clothes and to pull down the socks to expose the naked hairs, and then to lie down on the bed. The necklace and the watch do not have to be removed. First, apply the ankle cuffs. An ankle has a more complex structure involving more bones, muscles, and three arteries compared with the arms. Therefore, arm cuffs only cannot produce accurate measurement values. The specially designed ankle cuffs and proprietary algorithm ensure measurement accuracy and perform similarly to the Doppler method. Ankle cuffs of the VPE1000 Plus can double chamber structure, in which one part compresses the blood vessels and the other part detects the pulses. The structure allows measurement accuracy equivalent to the Doppler method. Place the tag on the ankle and apply the toe side band family around the hood very tight. By holding the root of the band, you can wrap the hood without any looseness, so that you can obtain accuracy. Firmly apply the cuffs with a tag placed on the crease, so that they will not loosen. If blood pressure measurement is not possible due to a shunt or amputation, you can choose the measurement site on the touch panel. Then, attach the ECG clip to the list. If the R wave cannot be detected, reattach only left wrist clip to the left foot. Place the phonocardiogram or PCG sensor on the left sternal border at the fourth intercostal space. To avoid noise, put a weight on the sensor. Then, enter the patient information. If this is the first measurement for the patient, he or she may be tense. Explain the procedure so that the patient can relax. Ask the patient to take a deep breath a few times. Make sure that ECG OK and PCG OK are indicated before starting the measurement. Now, how fast is the BP worse and the plus? From the time you push the start button, it takes approximately 45 seconds to obtain one reading. Because blood pressure fluctuates, BP worse and plus reads 2 times, and it takes about 2 minutes in total. In the second measurement, the detection timing is automatically adjusted based on the blood pressure value of the first measurement. By simultaneous measurement at all 4 limbs, accurate ABA measurement is possible with BP worse and plus. Synchronized measurement function can be turned off when it is safer for a patient. And the system generates 2 times of vascular profile light on the spot. One is for the doctor and another is for the patient. This section clearly shows the ABI for each leg as well as each BAPWV. Waveforms are indicated to assist the patient's arterial condition with ABI. BP worse and plus has successfully realized highly accurate and simple measurement. This is a report for clinicians where ABI and BAPWV results are displayed. In this case, the right ankle ABI is 0.97 and the left ankle ABI is 0.82. The plus waveforms have a gentle slope. BAPWV is 2,750 on the right and 1,977 on the left. What diagnosis would you make in this case?
In this case, the left ankle ABI is lower at 0.82, indicating the presence of stenosis. Thus, the patient can be diagnosed as having PAD. The problem is how we see the right ankle ABI of 0.97, which is close to the border. However, concerning BAPW data, the right leg has a considerably high value and there is a large difference between the right and the left sides. In the MRA contrast image of this case, 50% stenosis of the left femoral arteries was found as expected. In addition, mild stenosis was also seen in the right femoral artery, which had the borderline ABI value. As you can see, even in patients in whom the ABI value is 0.9 or greater, the risk for vascular disease can be detected by simultaneous measurement of BAPWV.
What is the prognosis for peripheral arterial disease? In the German epidemiological trial investigate the relationship between PAD and mortality. PAD was shown to be associated with increased risk for premature mortality and cardiovascular and cerebrovascular events. Even the category of normal ABI or asymptomatic ABI patients, the mortality and vascular morbidity risk was 20% every year. Atherosclerosis is a systemic disease that affects coronary, cerebral, and lower extremity arteries. The routine use of ABI measurements to assess the risk for premature death and vascular events has important prognostic value. Early screening, early treatment are essential. Vesical ankle pulseway velocity, or VAPWV, is also reported as a variable prognostic index. A study that have followed over 2,400 people for 6.5 years has shown that the cumulative hazard risk for all-cause mortality was progressively and significantly greater with increasing VAPWV data. The Takashima study is a population-based prospective cohort study. The participants were recruited from the governmental health checkup in Takashima County located in central Japan. The mortality for the highest tertile was significantly higher than that for the lowest tertile. This association of VAPWV with all-cause mortality was independent of age, sex, systolic blood pressure, and other factors in the general population. VAPWV would be ideal for large-scale population screening and for incorporation into routine clinical settings. With VPWAS Nano Plus, you will be able to measure several useful indices, including the PAD diagnosis algorithm of Task 2, such as ABI, PVL, pulse volume recording, DVI, and post-exercise ABI. Furthermore, post-exercise ABI test and TBA measurement can be performed on patients with borderline ABI and those with suspected calcified arteries, respectively. Clinicians finally have a tool easily, allows efficient diagnosis of PAD among both symptomatic and asymptomatic patients.